keep looking at you because I keep hearing God say something about you. He says, you're mine. He said, before you ever thought about me, I've always thought about you. And he says, you're beautiful to me. And he says, no matter what people say or what people have said about you or what you've gone through, God says, I've always had my eye on you. You're special. I created you that way, just for me. You understand what I'm saying? And he says, you're my possession. You're my prize. And he says, I love you. And he says, I always have and I always will. Yes. Before you knew about me, I loved you. And I don't know why I felt like the urge to say this, but I do just feel like God is saying that he cares.
Yes.
And I don't know where it's coming from, but...
So as we transition into this time for the baptisms, if you have a family member or friend that is getting baptized and you want to take pictures, you're more than welcome. But if you can kind of stand to the side, that would be helpful.
Indeed, I baptize you with water unto repentance. But he who is coming after me is mightier than I. His shoes I'm not worthy to even carry or unlatch. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and with fire. His winnowing fan is in his hand, and he will thoroughly clean out his threshing floor and gather his to the barn, but he will also burn up the chaff with unquenchable fire. Then Jesus came from Galilee to John at the Jordan to be baptized of him. And John tried to prevent him, saying, I need to be baptized by you, and you are coming to me? And Jesus answered and said to him, permit it to be so, for thus it is fitting for us to fulfill all righteousness. Then he allowed him. And when he had been baptized, Jesus came up and from the water, and behold, the heavens opened up to him. And he saw the Spirit of God descending like a dove and lighting upon him. And suddenly a voice came from heaven saying, this is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased. I just wanted to tell you that baptism is an outward expression of what's going on the inside. But one thing that happens is, when you honor God, God will speak up for you. The Bible says that the heavens opened up, God began to speak for him, and God identified him and said, this is my beloved Son, whom I'm well pleased. And God, the Bible says that we are now joint heirs with Christ. So when we accept Christ and we do things like this, God will begin to speak up for us. And that's what this thing is all about. Listen, your understanding will begin to grow day by day. The thing that you do will begin to grow day by day. As you begin to believe, things begin to become revealed to you day by day. But it's a day by day thing. God is a God loves you, and he's willing to accept you. So, last week, my sweetie came to me, and she was like, I want to get baptized. And she gave me a scripture, John 3:16. And we wrestled. She was going to do that. She didn't care what nobody said. My baby's going to get baptized. She was going to baptize me. And so now today is your day, sweetheart. So we're going to ask you a question. What is your name? What is your name? Amen. Do you believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God? And so why do you want to be baptized today?
So this is my great niece and my niece beyond. I think it's a privilege and honor to be able to do this.
Yeah, yeah.
Amen.
Yes.
So, by the authority and by the power of the Lord Jesus Christ, I baptize you, my daughter, in the name of Jesus.
I've been waiting for this one. This is my baby right here. And so, even though I know your name, I called it 1,000 times. I want you to read it to everybody.
Jewel.
Listen.
Okay.
And so, Jewel, do you believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God?
Yes.
And so, why do you want to be baptized?
Because I love Jesus.
Just being honest, this has always been like an important thing to me. I've always wanted to do this. I got one more person, two more people I always wanted to do it with. But this is my big brother, for those of you who don't know. He's like, I don't want to embarrass him, but he's like one of my first definitions of everything. And so I love my big brother, and I've always wanted to baptize with him. There is no big brother better than this one, I'm telling you. He's like all of my relationships. I seek to treat people the way he treated me. You know what I mean? He's always loved me out of strength. And even when I couldn't do anything, he's always been there to encourage me. He's always been there to lift me up. He's a couple times he got me in the chest. You know what I mean? But, you know, I've always loved my big brother. So I've always wanted to baptize people with him. And so I'm glad you're here today. You know what I mean? And so next up, I met his dad a long time ago in men's group, and his dad is a very prophetic person in my life, and so he's a good friend. But I want you, this is about you, I want you to tell me your name.
Marjorie Lorenzo.
And so, sir. All right,
man.
Yes. And do you believe Jesus Christ is the Son of God?
Absolutely.
And did you want to get baptized today? Okay, so this is one of my other sweethearts. Remember the story I told you last week about her sister telling me she wanted to play, but this is the other one. And ever since we were beside each other, every time I've come outside, I've always saw those two. And I just love these two little girls. They're not little anymore. They're grown up to be teenagers. But I told them the other day how proud I was of them. And I'm excited to see what they're going to become one day. And so I want you to tell them everybody your name. All right. And you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God? And what's the reason why you want to be baptized? So it's with the power and authority invested. We baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name. This is my girl in 50 Pearl. Tell everybody your name.
Kiara.
Kiara gave me a notorious name years ago when she first met me. Can you tell everybody what she used to call me?
Mr. Hermit Crab.
And she said, now you're Pastor Hermit Crab. But I've always loved her ever since she was a little girl. And so, why are... Do you believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God?
Yes.
And why are you getting baptized on today?
Because I love the Lord and I want to start off fresh.
You want to start off fresh?
Amen.
Good. I want you to know that anytime something goes wrong, you can always start off fresh.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. No matter what it is, you can always say, God, forgive me. I need a do-over.
Amen.
Okay? And he will give you a do-over.
Amen.
As long as you're on this side of the earth, you get.
Amen.
And love. Okay?
Amen.
All right. So, with the power and authority invested in me, we now baptize you in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost, in Jesus' name. General. She's an ROTC legend. She will be joining the military soon. got her when she was about this big. And she used to tell on everybody. Amen. So tell everybody what your name is, sweetheart.
My name is Destiny.
My name is Destiny. And do you believe in Jesus Christ as the Son of God?
Yes.
And so why do you want to be baptized on today?
Because I want to be beginning
in His path. You want to be beginning
in what? In His
path. Okay. She wants a new beginning in His path. Mm-hmm. Amen. Destiny, I am proud of you. All right? So when you go and you become a general and you do everything you're supposed to do, I want you to remember me, okay? I'm going to get you out of there, all right?
Okay.
All right. So, and so with the power and authority invested in us, we baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. In Jesus' name. So, sir.
Let me turn it off and tell it.
And so, sir, can you give everybody your name?
Curtis.
This is my buddy Curtis. He came to us about 5 years ago. Hallelujah, man. And Curtis, you have never stopped to amaze me. You've always provided my life with laughter and fun, and you've always been a great guy. So, I'm really proud of the decision you're making today, okay? And so, why? Do you believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God?
Yes.
You have to confess that. And why are you being baptized?
For another chance. I want to follow Christ, and I want to ask God to give me hope again.
Amen. Amen.
So, Father God, before we baptize him, I pray over Curtis that you would restore and that you would renew and that you would give him hope. And so, God, unexpected. You said it above all things, that you wish that he would prosper and be in good health, even if his soul prospers. And so, God, I speak life over him, that his soul would prosper, and that you would give him a hope in the future and expect him. And God, when I call on you, God, I pray that you would answer. And so, Curtis, it's our duty and our privilege to baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, in Jesus' name. So we're going to you all can just stand. Why don't you give those who were baptized a round of applause? Pastor, thank you for this idea. I took a lot of prayer. Thank you.
Amen.
Praying that into
existence.
Yeah. Amen. The last couple of weeks, we saw fathers baptizing their daughters. We saw families getting baptized together. Amen. Because that's what this holiday is all about. And so, we bless you. We speak life over you. I pray that your enemies would come at you one way, but flee in seven.
Yes.
But most importantly, we pray that you would have an encounter with God. That God would walk all things out according to the counsel of his own godliness in your life. I speak life that God would touch you in a way that would make you want to touch him. I speak a divine encounter with God. I speak favor over you. I speak life over you, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. We speak it over you right now. We pray, God, that you would do on this next year, God, exceedingly abundantly above all that they can ask or think.
Yes.
And so we bless you. We worship you. We praise you.
Yes.
In Jesus' name.
Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Listen, go in peace and enjoy the favor of the Lord. Amen. And hug somebody on your way out. Amen.